good. It seems like we're having some connection issues. Hopefully it's gonna be fine. Mom was watching a video, but my connection's fast enough to handle both. Yeah, the stream went red a couple times, so I'm just kind of like on edge at the moment. Yeah, we're gonna go, but I'm just yeah. All right, we are back. These are the points. See how it goes. Okay, we're having connection issues with the stream. So I might need to keep checking because I got disconnected like three. Verstappen dropped to fourth. That's what you miss when I got to restart the internet. Which means I got to start a new stream. That's bugging me. That's. Oh my days. Well, we get what we take, I guess. Verstappen fifth. How have I got driver of the day there? Our points leader would have wanted. Hopefully it doesn't disconnect while I do this. It's time to check the sprint out the constructor points. Standing. Right now I gotta do the inevitable, I have to restart the bloody stream. So I think we're back.
This is it then, race day in Spielberg for this year's Austrian Grand Prix. Not long to go before our drivers hurtle off the line and into the first turn. The Niki Lauda Curve. It was renamed in 2019 in memory of one of Formula One's most beloved figures. It's a short lap here in Spielberg with just 10 corners, 7 to the right and 3 to the left, making up the total distance of 2.6 miles. And expect to see a lot of cars running wide today, especially through the last corner, as the wet conditions make the cars skittish through the downhill sections. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Lando Norris.
Don't know what happened to Max, but he was keeping up in second place. And then he dropped to fifth in the end. Last lap he dropped from like third to fifth. Couldn't believe my eyes.
Oscar Piastri, Max Verstappen, and Gasly. Davidson, Magnussen, Deruvola, and Yuki Tsunoda. Albon, Tiktum.
A lot of Asians here.
Esteban Ocon. Mick
like five in a row.
Schwartzman, Stroll, Sebastian Vettel, and Richard Vachon. Russell, Joe, Theo Pourchaire, and Yuri Vips. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway.
What flag is that? Is that Estonia for Vips? Just curious. We'll do that. Yeah, that's what we're doing. We're not actually gonna do that, but it's projected that it will be dry towards the end. So I'm trying to like not pit at all on these tires. See if that works out for me.
Right then, the formation lap has started. And I must say the weather conditions aren't the best today for visibility and for grip.
driver performs this lap, they'll be wanting to settle in and concentrate, as this race, in these conditions, will require a lot of focus. As the cars come back towards the grid to line up for the start of the race, each driver will be wanting to get the best start they possibly can, and they'll be hoping to finish today's race on the podium, failing that, within the points.
Damn you! I've given up! Yeah, I'm done. I'm done for. I don't deserve anything after trying to play dirty like that. I'm not going to complain about it. I just hate the fact that I can't compete in the rain. I just hate that. Like, I get that I'm bad at the game, but like, at least in a dry I can at least challenge someone. I can't compete with anyone in the rain. Like, how is a fully upgraded car so slow in the rain compared to the AI? It can't simply be down to I'm bad at the game. I am, but I'm playing on level 60. And sure, in the dry I'm not winning races either, but like, I can at least... Oh, you flopping... You idiots! Is he pitting? Is that why? Yeah, he's pitting. That's why. I thought they were competing with each other. Avatari are like the fourth slowest car. Look how much faster they are just because it's wet. Got some breathing room, but I'm 9, so it's terrible.
separates you. They're on a fresh set of inters. Okay, gap to leader, 10.3 seconds. 34 laps to go.
Magnussen, I say Magnussen dropped off a bit more. Like, what happened to him? He was a bit closer than that to the back of the pack.
front is 6.6 seconds.
Yeah, just there, just there.
That's out from behind you. Okay, the gap is less than a second. They're on a fresh set of inches. The distance to the leader is 16.9 seconds. Ahead is 7.4 seconds. It's still not a perfect situation, but I don't think we've got cause to move on to a different tyre yet. Thank you. say you're okay.
Trying to hold on to ninth. Not Bengals at all. It's not raining anymore. I mean, it is slightly. Depends on the part of the track, I guess. Clouds work in mysterious ways.
Okay, you're closing on one of the Ferraris.
Am I?
Okay, gap ahead is 10.7 seconds.
That's closing in to you, is it? It was like 9 seconds 2 laps ago.
Seconds.
hope it rains a few more minutes just so everyone can pit the inters, and then they have to pit twice and the other two have to pit once. I'm playing chess, but they're playing checkers. Although I'd be playing the checkers if they start switching to slicks. Then it's like, oh, right, the long game has not worked.
Our gap to the car in front is 12.2 seconds.
Damn it. I thought it might work. It's not gonna work. Didn't work.
Look after these tires now, and we'll finish the race on this compound.
Where's the DRS? Stewards, enable them now. Thank you. internet gone bad again, bro? Internet issues again, God's sake. But I don't have it. Bloody prick. God's sake. I can't believe internet crashed again mid-race. Thank you.
passing the car ahead. Well done, but be aware these tyres need to get us to the end of this race.
Verstappen and that Ferrari having a good battle. Their position changed like 5 times in one straight. Surely I could compete like that. That would be nice. Ah, DRS. Yes. I like it. All these components are fine before the sprint race. They didn't even, you know, they weren't even close to going yellow. All it took was the sprint and half of this, and suddenly it's gone. I mean, it's fair, like, it was gonna happen. We haven't changed components for the whole season yet. It's race 5 now, but still, the fact that it was all okay before the weekend and then now we're in trouble with two components. It's a bit of a hammer blow. It is.
P10, you're currently in P10, and that's ticked to the head now. Okay, gap ahead is 5.5 seconds. They're on old mediums. Ocon's behind you, and the gap behind us is 2.0 seconds. They're on old mediums. Okay, so gap to the leader is 40.4 seconds. Our last stop, no more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. We're currently trailing our teammate by 30.6 seconds. Our gap to the car in front is 5.7 seconds. To catch the car in front, but we need to look after the tyres. We won't be making another pit stop.
I'm not catching the car in front, am I? Stop making up bollocks lies, bro. That's a McLaren's Lando Norris starter session. That means Sainz is now winning and Verstappen's now second. And I'm gonna be ninth. Yay!
Okay, gap to the car ahead is 5.8 seconds.
That race weekend is a journey. How?
Smiling faces on the pit wall then after that superb win here in Spain.
The fact that internet kept disconnecting really annoyed me there. How's it started raining again? What do you mean? It was dry just now.
Made the difference out there today.
I think that smart time management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Red Bull put up an outstanding fight for the front position today, and it's great to see it paid off for them. They do so much for the sport that you can't help but be delighted by today's race win. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. This result narrows the gap between our championship leader and
the overall points, of course.
Let's focus on the driver of the day, Anthony Davidson. Who do you pick?
Well, on Stroll would be
there
my
pick. There
you go,
Verstappen passes lap as well.
Whilst pushing through the
we
field.
Take those.
Let's move on to the constructors. No change at the top spot then, but with today's points...
So Verstappen's still winning with 21 points, weaker. But it's all to play for right now. I've dropped down, obviously, and, you know, 36 points is the difference now to Red Bull. They will be competing with us. They will be competing with us. Let's see. I mean, the rivalry, I don't think will go well. Sainz is literally my rival. I should have picked whoever the heavy option was. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, it's going to be over soon. At least we got these. It's mainly because of the sprint, if I'm being honest, but at least we got them.
Let's take it slow. Where you go, I go too. And if you hit the bottom, I'm going down with you. Let's take it slow. Who cares where we gotta be? You know you'll have a good time wherever you're.